You would think, if the world was simple, that if you're depressed and cold, I should heat you up. And if you're depressed and hot, I should cool you down. But in fact, the opposite is true. So in the European study, we actually very successfully measured core body temperature the day before they got to treatment, yeah. 5 days after, right? And what we found was that the hotter you were before you got into the box, the better antidepressant response you got.
I was going to ask you about that.
Right. And what we found from 5 days after being in the box, everybody's core body temperature was really lower over 24 hours. So the box didn't make people hotter, it made them cooler. What we were actually inducing was hypothermia. Hmm. We used hyperthermia to induce hypothermia.
Long term, you mean?
Longer term.
Right. Mm-hmm. Which and would be like a hormone, almost like a hormone.
It is.
Yeah.
It is a hormone system, right? Yeah. We toughened the system.
Yeah.
We toughened up the system. We recalibrated. We made, so what we think, what, and this is really the work of my colleague Christopher Lowry at UC Boulder in Colorado. What we think we've done is sensitize thermoregulatory cooling pathways so that the heat actually exercised them in some ways or shocked them into being more sensitive. And there's a giant literature on this fact that thermoregulation is impaired, as we said, in depression.
Yeah.
Depressed people can't cool off. They can't sweat, they can't cool off. And so what we think we've done is sensitize the pathways in the brain and the body that mediate those effects, and that's a marker for that sort of, we've also then strengthened anti-inflammatory,
or
anti-depressant
pathways.
It'd be interesting
to look at, like, dynorphin, that whole system, because that is
I know, because it's also what do they call it, a cryogen.
Yeah.
It cools.
You know, don't schizophrenics also have a similar problem in terms of thermoregulation?
They do. They've got horrible, they've got really, really crazy thermoregulatory challenges, right? So, I mean, when you see folks out, you know, it's a tragedy. When you see them out on the street, one of the things you notice about schizophrenics is it can be hot and they're wearing 3 or 4 coats, right? So they really, really have thermoregulatory problems. And if I think about it for a minute, I'll be able to tell you. There's a study, though, where they found that they do better. So what do they do better with? They do worse with cold and better with heat, or they do worse with heat? One of the two. But but it's interesting that it's
the
not all bad.
Yeah,
but
their
thermoregulation is absolutely whacked.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, you see this. I mean, you see these guys, you know, and women. Right. So it's not just depression.